It's easy to assume that your memory works like a camera. You know how cameras work, so it's like how memories work. You take snapshots of your life, and sometimes it's hard to find a picture, or you accidentally delete one, but the ones you keep are a good record of what actually happened. But psychologists who study memory actually think it works more like a Wikipedia page. You can trust it as a general reference, but every time you remember something, you can make changes to it, and so can other people. In fact, there are lots of ways your mind can be tricked into thinking things happened that never actually did. One way is through suggestion, basically dropping hints that something happened a certain way. A psychology study in the mid-1970s was one of the first to show the power of verbal suggestions. In one experiment, the researchers played college students' videos of a car crash, and then asked some questions about the crash. One group was asked how fast they thought the cars were going when they hit each other. Another was asked how fast the cars were going when they smashed each other. And that word choice affected their memory. When the researchers said smashed instead of hit, people's estimates of the speed increased by about 3 miles per hour. Then, when the psychologists followed up a week later, they asked if the participants remembered seeing broken glass in the video, which, for the record, there wasn't. Of the 50 people who heard the word smashed, 16 remembered seeing broken glass that wasn't actually there, as opposed to 7 of the 50 people who heard the word hit. Even without the suggestion, a few people were remembering incorrectly, but not as many. Now, that wasn't a huge study, but the power of suggestion has been replicated hundreds of times in different experiments, so it seems like we're pretty prone to getting little details wrong. Turns out, we're also bad at remembering where we heard something in the first place, or whether something actually happened to us instead of, like, dreaming it up. This is known as source misattribution. In one study, psychologists tested for this effect by inviting some 210 volunteers into a lab for a couple of days, and asking them to either do or imagine doing a bunch of different things. There were familiar tasks like smelling a flower, plus some weird ones like tapping a flower to their forehead. Then, 2 weeks later, they were asked to remember what they did. It didn't matter if it was something normal like rolling dice or strange like sitting on dice. Over half the time, participants thought they actually did the things they only imagined. And if they spent more time imagining an action, they were more likely to think they really did it. Now, both of these memory flaws have been psychologists sort of messing with people, but sometimes we just unintentionally make stuff up. These are called spontaneous false memories. This is when all the knowledge and patterns you have swimming around in your brain can mess up what you remember. Let me show you. Try to remember this list of words. Think you have them memorized? Okay, good. Now take a look at these words. How many of them were on that first list? In case you were wondering and didn't just write them down, the answer is 6. But in controlled lab experiments, where people do have a little more time to memorize, most people will falsely remember one word that wasn't on the first list. Window. That's because the first list was basically a bunch of window-related words, so it's easy for your mind to make a goof. This example is called a DRM list, named after the psychologists who wrote and studied it, Dies, Roediger, and McDermott. But spontaneous false memories can happen in all kinds of situations. For instance, one study showed children between 5 and 12 years old different versions of a video where a teacher read a story to a class and then got money stolen from her wallet in a cafeteria. Then they had to pick the thief out of a lineup. In one version of the video, there was a bystander next to the teacher while she was reading, someone who was about the same age, build, gender, and ethnicity as the thief. And after watching that version, the 11 to 12-year-olds were more likely to pick the innocent person out of the lineup than the actual thief. This is called unconscious transference, when an innocent person gets misremembered as a criminal because of the way your mind categorizes things like how they look. Psychologists think we make up these patterns as we go through life, most of the time without thinking about it. They've also noticed that adults usually show unconscious transference and mix up DRM lists more than really young children do, because they just have more life experience and general knowledge. So, memory is kind of scarily unreliable, and it's probably worth taking your own memory with a grain of salt. But now that you know some of the ways your own mind can trick you, maybe you can avoid being too trusting. You know, Pixar, it didn't happen. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow Psychology, especially to our patrons on Patreon, without whom this show would not exist. If you want to support us, you can go to patreon.com/scishow. And we have 2 new psychology videos for you every single week. All you gotta do is go to youtube.com/scishowpsych and subscribe.